Welcome to a series of videos from Klippa about the Klippa Scanner SDK. My name is Jeroen Bobbeldijk, I'm the CTO of Klippa, and I'm going to show you step by step how to implement the Klippa Scanner SDK into your own application. Our Klippa Scanner SDK allows you to take pictures with the phone and automatically color correct and crop them. Today, I will show you how to implement the Klippa Scanner SDK into your own Android application. Before we start, make sure that you have Android Studio completely installed and that it's working, and also that you have a working emulator to start this application in. Also make sure that you have a license requested with us so that you can actually start the SDK. If you don't have this license or a username and password, you can't use this SDK. So make sure to get one. If you don't have one yet, you can contact us and we can generate one for you. So as a first step, we are going to create an empty project in Android Studio. So go to New in the menu and select New Project. As a base project, we are going to use Basic Activity, and we are going to name it Klippa Scanner Demo. Because this template contains some parts that we are not going to use for this tutorial, we are going to remove them. So start by removing the Options menu. So what you want to do is delete two methods from the main activity class, namely onCreateOptions menu and onOptionsItemSelected. We are also going to remove the menu main from the rest folder because we are not going to use it for the menu options anymore. Removing this part of the code will ensure that the three dots in your menu bar are removed because we are not going to use the menu bar at all. Next up are the navigation fragments. We are not going to use any navigation fragments because everything happens in one activity. We want to start with a clean environment, so we are not going to use any of those. We basically only want to keep the round button in the right bottom corner to start the camera. So what we're going to do is remove all the layouts from the layouts folder, except for activity main, where our activity happens. We are going to remove the navigation folder from res. Next up is you want to open the activity main XML file and remove the include for the content main XML. And as the last cleanup part, you are going to remove the first and the second fragment. When you start the app now, you can see that we have a really clean app and that you only have a round button in the right bottom corner. It now contains an email icon, and we are going to change it to a camera icon because we are going to start a camera SDK with it. You can change the icon on the round button by opening the activity main XML file and editing the drawable from IC main dialog to IC menu camera. When you click the button now, you will get the default functionality of the Android snack bar, which is the little notification that you can see in the bottom of the screen. We are going to change this by replacing it with starting the Klippa Scanner SDK. As you can see in the documentation, there are a few steps to take. The first step to take is adding our Gradle repository to our top-level build.gradle file. So copy the repository information from the documentation and open the top-level build.gradle file from your project. You are going to want to paste this information in the repositories object. Be aware that you need to enter your credentials in this repository information. You can get this information from us. If you don't have this information yet, please request this because without this information, you can't complete this tutorial. We are going to add our implementation to the dependencies object in your Gradle file. This will make sure that the Gradle build will actually download the Klippa SDK scanner dependency into your project. Gradle will actually know when you change anything to the Gradle files. What you will need to do is press the Sync Now button so Gradle can update all its dependencies and will download the scanner SDK automatically for you. Now we are going to start the camera SDK with the button that we changed the icon of. What you will want to do is copy the example code of the request code and also the start Klippa scanner method. When you import it into Android Studio, it will automatically tell you that it's not written in Kotlin but in Java, but that it will be able to convert it to you. So if you press yes, it will automatically convert this code into Kotlin and you can directly use it. Now you want to change the onClick listener of the button to actually call the start Klippa scanner method. You also need a license to get it to work. For this license, you need multiple things. For Android, this is the package ID and also a signed key hash. For your debug build, this means it's a signed key hash of your debug build key. you can find your package ID in the Android manifest.xml file. To get your signed key hash, execute the following command in your terminal. It is possible that your debug key store is in a different location. There are a lot of tutorials on the internet that can tell you where it is on your operating system. The debug key store password is always Android. In the example code, there is a piece of text that says replace with received license. This is where you're going to put your license. It is possible that you will get a license mismatch. That means that something is wrong in the information that you provided to us. For example, a wrong package ID or a wrong hash. The only thing left is adding something that can handle coming back from the scanner with the result. Basically, this will call method when you return from your newly created activity, in this case, the Klippa scanner. In the result of the onActivity result, you can find the result images and the preferences that the user selected. We can also copy this code from the documentation. However, Android Studio can't completely rewrite it in Kotlin for you. You have to make some changes on your run. We will also add a tag for our logs so that we can easily recognize the log messages in the console. Go to the documentation and copy the code of onActivity result. Paste it into Android Studio, and when it asks you to convert to Kotlin, press yes. Also, insert the following line into your code. Var tag is Klippa scanner demo. This will make it easier to recognize the log lines. So the first problem is that the method is marked as protected, but this is not correct. The function should be override because it's overriding a method in the parent clause. Replace the protected keyword with override. Another problem is that the function signature does not perfectly match the function signature of the parent clause, so we are going to change that. Android Studio has a nifty function for that. If you press Alt-Enter, you can automatically fix the function signature to match the parent clause. To get the logging to work, you're going to need to import the log class. Right-click on the log keyword, press Show Context Actions and Import Class. Android Studio is automatically able to do this for you. Do the same with the file keyword. Right-click, Show Context Actions, and Import. Because the data of the intent can be null, we have to safeguard the condition by adding a null check. You can do this by adding two exclamation marks. You can see that the only problem that's left now is in the getParsableArrayList_extra method. Because it can't automatically detect the result class, you have to add it yourself. We also have to add some extra null checks here. We are now ready to start the scanner. Start your application and press on the Start Camera button. You can now see that your camera is working and that you can take pictures. Play around with it a little bit and see if you like it. As you can see from the documentation page, there are also a lot of options to play around with. Please test them out and let us know if you have any problems. That was it for today. I hope you were successful in implementing the Klippa Scanner SDK in your own application. If you have any questions, please contact us or leave a comment below. And also, please like and subscribe if you want to follow Klippa.